in high definition. CBS 3 Eyewitness News.
The former president of Penn State University is now criminally charged for his role in the Jerry Sandusky sex abuse scandal. Prosecutors made the announcement in Harrisburg this afternoon. Eyewitness News reporter Ben Simino was there, and he has the latest on the charges.
There were lies told. There was obstruction of justice, and it made it very difficult to find the truth in this particular case.
Longtime Penn State president Graham Spanier lied and covered up what he knew about two incidents involving convicted child abuser Jerry Sandusky, says Pennsylvania's attorney general, who filed criminal charges against the once respected university leader and added charges against former university vice president Gary Schultz and athletic director Tim Curley, who were already charged with perjury.
This was not a mistake by these men. It was not an oversight. It was not misjudgment on their part. This was a conspiracy of silence by top officials working to actively conceal the truth.
Citing emails, the grand jury report says Spanier lied under oath when he denied knowing about an incident involving Sandusky and victim six in showers at Penn State back in 1998. Authorities say this email exchange between Spanier, Curley, and Schultz shows Spanier also knew about a 2001 assault reported by Mike McQueary, and Spanier approved a plan not to notify authorities about that, but instead speak with Sandusky, even though he acknowledged, quote, "The only downside for us is if the message isn't heard and acted upon, and we then become vulnerable for not having reported it."
I think it is disgraceful that the president of a major American institution of higher learning would fail to take into account that the victims came first.
Meanwhile, Spanier's attorneys say Pennsylvania Governor Tom Corbett, the former attorney general, is behind these charges.
To cover up and divert attention away from the fact that he failed to warn the Penn State community about the suspicions surrounding Jerry Sandusky.
Now, that video statement was provided by the law firm representing Graham Spanier. We did not have an opportunity to ask his lawyers any questions today. A lot of the documents connected to these charges were first released in the Free Report this summer, which also implicated former head football coach Joe Paterno. And the attorney general was asked today if Paterno would have been charged had he lived, and she refused to answer that question. In the news center, I'm Ben Simino, CBS 3 Eyewitness News.